Good evening, you're watching the Indian Express and we are back with our daily updates on the Bihar elections. Till the election results are declared, every day we will bring you three key developments you need to follow to be up to date with all that is happening in this extremely absorbing elections. Today was the last day of campaigning. November 7 is the third phase of voting, after which the results will be declared on November 10. Very first thing we have for you today is this explosive announcement by Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar, who has said that he will not be contesting elections anymore. At a rally in Purnia, Nitish said this was his last election and that he would not be in the poll battle again. Making what sounded rather like an emotional appeal, Nitish said that ye mera antim chunav hai aur ant bhala to sab bhala, to bataiye aap hame vote denge ya nahi, which translates that this is my last election and all that ends well, so tell me if you will vote for me. Now, the announcement in itself is a big deal, but the way it has come is also very dramatic. At Nitish's very last rally for the elections, at a public rally, it has come totally out of the blue. We do not know whether alliance partner BJP was aware of Nitish's plans. Now, of course, the CM is 69, so there had always been talks about his possible successor and how there was no direct line of, obvious line of succession in the JDU, and even the BJP does not have a CM face in Bihar. But with this announcement, Nitish has thrown the proverbial stone in the beehive, and suddenly LJP and all that Chirag Paswan had been doing can be seen in a new light, because Chirag had been insisting, flying in the face of all poll math, Chirag had been insisting that he would form the government along with the BJP. So with this new announcement, we don't know what exactly is happening there. RLSP's Upendra Kushwaha has already reacted to Nitish's announcement. He has said that Nitish has made this announcement at the right time, and now it is high time that he steps away and gives his blessings to the younger brother, meaning Kushwaha himself. When the time to decide a successor for Nitish arrives, there is very likely to be a clamor among the upper castes that the leader should be from their community. The upper castes have been a loyal supporter of the NDA all these years, but they have not had a prominent leader in many years and they have not had a chief minister in almost 30 years now. So there is very likely to be that demand from among the upper castes, and in that case, Nityanand Rai's name comes to mind, but really there are no obvious successors here. Second important development is that in the third phase, the Muslim-dominated Simanchal region will be going to polls. So both Nitish and Tejasvi have spoken about CA and NRC. Nitish has said that there are people who are spreading rubbish about the new laws, but nobody can send anyone out of the country and everyone belongs to Hindustan, and nobody has the strength to drive anyone out of the country. Tejasvi, on the other hand, has said that he did not name CANRC. What he said was that the central government has been bringing in laws that harass people, and we have stood by you during those times, meaning the RJD, and hence we should stay united right now. Tejasvi has also said that do not be swayed by outsiders, which is being read as a reference to AIMIM and Asaduddin Owaisi. Nitish also reminded the people about how he has done a lot for madrasas, he has recognized a lot of madrasas and he has increased the salary of madrasa teachers. So Muslim voter wooing has been happening. An important thing to remember is that in the 2019 Lok Sabha polls, Simanchal region was the one region from where Mahagathbandhan got its one seat in Bihar. Has written a letter to the people of Bihar. The letter was tweeted just a few minutes ago. In the letter, the PM details the various schemes of the NDA that he says have worked for the people of Bihar, have fetched returns for the people of Bihar. And there are two interesting things in the letter. One is that he says that for the uninterrupted growth of Bihar, it is very necessary that the government of Nitish Kumar is brought back. So the CM has once again underlined that Nitish is very much the CM candidate this time. The second thing is that the PM has said that he is very happy that the discourse in this election was centered around Vikas. But the BJP leaders, in fact, a lot of leaders who came to campaign spoke about a lot of non-Vikas issues. They talked about how are Tejasvi Yadav and Rahul Gandhi back anti-India forces, how their rhetoric is very soft on Pakistan. Then the PM himself said that there are some people, some leaders who have a problem with Bharat Mata Ki Jai and Bihar would never accept such people. It was in fact the opposition which refused to rise to these baits and kept its campaign centered around the issue of jobs and around economic distress. So we are not quite sure whom the PM is congratulating here. For today, this is it. Join us again tomorrow. We'll be back. Thank you.